financial troubles of Rangers have been well documented over the past weeks and months, really since Craig White took control of the club. They have had this tax bill overhanging them, a disputed bill of £49 million thereabouts.
Still remember how the Rangers used to make me smile with Sebo and Frank de Boer. They were shite and they were poor, and maybe we were happy for a while. You spent what you could not afford, bought titles by a corrupt board. Then the tax man came to light, sent by the Queen to our delight. I can't remember if I cried tears of joy I could not hide, but something touched me deep inside the day the Rangers died. So bye bye, let the Rangers die. Oh, we're heading for a baby, let the Guinness run dry. Those good old boys in the fields of Bath and Rye, singing this'll be the day that you die, this'll be the day that you die. Now we can choose a club we love, but we had faith in God above. We even tried to tell you so. Now you believe in fairy tales, while every player's in the sails, and we were hoping that you'd die real slow. Well, you know that we just love this stuff. In fact, we just can't get enough. Every day in the news, another dig at those cheating blues. Well, you were sold for just a single buck on a pack of lies. Now you're out of luck, but you know we couldn't give a fuck the day the Rangers died. So bye bye, let the Rangers die. Oh, we're heading for a baby, let the Guinness run dry. Those good old boys in the fields of Bath and Rye, singing this'll be the day that you die, this'll be the day that you die. So bye bye, let the Rangers die. Oh, we're heading for a baby, let the Guinness run dry. Those good old boys in the fields of Bath and Rye, singing this'll be the day that you die, this'll be the day that you die.
Right, hold on, I'll just put in a response here to someone on the old Twitter. Shame. Hold on. Shame, the show has started. All you can do is watch, and not part of. Thank you. Right, enough and is enough there. So, what's his name? The Celtic Way. If you follow my Twitter line, you'll see the conversation I've had with someone who openly, well, to call someone of the Islamic faith a prophet, it's not good. It's not good, considering that we believe in the last prophet was Muhammad, peace be upon him, who came in a long chain of prophets. Oh, this guy just lining a punch up at some guy in the news. What's this? Pretty evil, that, isn't it? Yes.
His mother has called Gill's sentence an absolute joke.
Hey, what's happened?
With a single punch, could have his sentence reviewed. Lewis Gill killed Andrew Young, seen here wearing a white t-shirt, in November last year. Mr. Young had challenged Gill's friend for riding his bike on the pavement in Bournemouth. Andrew Young, who had Asperger's syndrome, died after a punch to the head. His mother has called Gill's sentence an absolute joke.
Well, look at the way he took the stance to that. That was an evil punch, that, wasn't it? That's twice in that news there. Someone just stopped the camera just before people were killed there. The poor boy at the...
In November last year, Mr. Young had challenged Gill's friend for riding his bike on the pavement in Bournemouth. Andrew Young, who had Asperger's syndrome, died after a punch to the head. His mother had called Gill's sentence an absolute joke.
So I just paused that and rewound it there. Look at that violence there. Yes. Hold on. Tunes, right, we're finished with that there. Right, I've posted on the huddle board. Are you doing all on the huddle board tonight? And let's see who's on there. Edo, how you doing? Kev? I know. Asperger's syndrome, I know. The world's a sick place, isn't it? A sick, sick place. Right. Have you retweeted to retweet? Have you told 10 to tell 10? Shocking if you haven't. Shocking, absolutely shocking. Right, it's too late to do the old calls of the British people to get people to change their minds, but what we can do is we'll go on the hunt for John Michael Glazer. Michael Glazer.